नित्यानंदेश्वर समारंभाम् नित्यानंदेश्वरी मध्यमाम् अस्मदाचार्य पर्यन्ताम् वंदे गुरु परंपराम्। I welcome all of you with my love and respects. I welcome everyone who is sitting with us through Nityananda TV, Sadhana TV, and two-way video conferencing, and RRTV. I welcome every one of you with my love and respects. City is sitting with us in two-way video conferencing, having Naina Deeksha, San Jose, Madurai, Kuala Lumpur, Palani, Seattle, Chidambaram, Toronto, Tirukkailayam, Melbourne, St. Louis, Tirumala, New York, Varanasi, Los Angeles, Ohio Temple, Oman, Sivagangai, Varanasi, Vancouver, Singapore, Dakota Dunes, Madurai, Ponca City, Oklahoma, Hyderabad Adinam, Hyderabad Guptakashi, Dubai Vaidyanatham, London Southwest, Tiruvannamalai Rajapalayam, Oklahoma, Guadalupe, China, Hyderabad, Charlotte, Hong Kong, and lot more cities. I welcome all of you with my love and respects. Today is the 9th day of Rajarajeshwari Brahmotsavam. Devi is gracing on Swarna Simhavahana, golden lion vehicle, blessing all of us. March 3rd, Jeevan Mukti Jayanti. It is not just my book, it is my Ananda Ganda. Whoever holds that book are holding my Ananda Ganda means pure consciousness, door to God, gateway to consciousness. So understand, Jeevan Mukti book has no expiry date. Still, it stands out to be the one of the best gifts I have given to the world, are delivered to the world through me. So, this whole month, let's celebrate by distributing Jeevan Mukti book in as many languages as possible as a gift to people. Today, whoever calls in they will receive Jivan Mukti book, the language you want, as much as stock available. If it is available in the Bidhi campus, it is available for you. You have to call in and tell in which language you want the Jivan Mukti book. It's a gift from our Sangha to all of you. One copy per person. Don't collect for selling or commercial purpose. It's only for personal spiritual purpose. You can call in and tell the book you want, the Jivan Mukti book you want, the language you want. Jivan Mukti. I have written many books earlier and after. Even then, the way that book makes sense and relates makes the whole science so easy. Incomparable. I am working on coming up with the second volume, third volume, but nothing can be compared to that. Nothing can be compared to that book. So with this, I'll enter into today's satsang, the fifth verse of Isavasya Upanishad. Taddejati Tanaijati तद्दूरे तत्वन्तिके तदन्तरस्य सर्वस्य ततु सर्वस्यास्य बाह्यतः तद्देजति तन्नेजति तद्दूरे तत्वन्तिके तदन्तरस्य सर्वस्य तदु सर्वस्यास्य बाह्यतः. That moves and that moves not, that's far off, that's also near, that is the inner space of all this, that is also the outer space of all this. I can go on repeating this verse, but we'll never be able to comment on it. Maybe I'll intercept and reveal the pretext, context, for all of you to understand the meaning and make it more user-friendly. Taddejati tannaijati tadure tatvandike tadantarasya sarvasya tadu sarvasyasya bahyatah. Anything moves and moves not should be beyond which moves and moves not. Understand the way to realize the reality. See, the way to perceive the perception is not to question it too much. If you question it, it'll melt down like a dream. The moment you start questioning the dream, dream will melt down. Dream always presents a completely illogical things in front of you. And if you question it, especially the person you, whom you really like appears in the dream, almost about to hug you, if you ask, how can this be possible so easily, the dream will disappear. Understand, the item which you always wanted to eat is in front of your table, you are about to eat. If you ask the question, how can this be possible so easily, the dream will disappear. Whenever you relate with perception, you have to do it very sensitively. You can't touch it. You can't question it. It is touch me not. Always your perception is touch me not. That is why when you question your love, it will disappear. All your so-called falling in love, the falling in love, the moment you question it, is it authentic? Straight away you will see, it lands on just the skin and skin color, not even skin deep. Perception, the moment you question, dissolves, disappears. Next, fact will stand the scrutiny of logic, but not larger life logic. Listen, fact will stand the scrutiny of logic, but not larger life logic. For example, if somebody makes a statement, Earth is flat, yes, it will stand the scrutiny of your simple logic, straightforward logic. It looks flat, so it's flat, but it won't stand the larger logic, which you can understand with various equipments, not just with your empty eyes. The larger logic, the facts are such, it will stand the scrutiny of ordinary logic, but not the larger logic. Truth will stand anything which you can grasp, like a logic, larger logic, machineries, the scientific discovery, research. Truth will stand for anything, but still it is not reality. It won't stand the scrutiny of the consciousness. Reality is the one, only one, which can stand the scrutiny of the consciousness. Understand, all confusions in the world is the fight between perception, fact, truth, reality. Whether it is in the field of religion, science, spirituality, logic, law, mathematics, any field. It is just a fight between perception, fact, truth, and reality. Blessed are those who are always established on realization of reality. I tell you, the most non-suffering way of existence is establishing yourself in reality. Do not go for perceiving about you, life or God based on what larger number of people say. They do not know and they don't have time to analyze, scrutinize. Second, don't go with your calculation. You know how to calculate only your salary. A person who receives 1 lakh salary can never imagine or perceive raising and spending $1 zillion. No. It takes a literally transformation. Understand? If it goes above your head, listen to the satsang once or twice. Participate in the Vakyartha Sadas. Listen now what I am saying. Don't decide what is God, who is God, based on what larger number of people tell you. Never think because larger number of people tell, it's truth. No. Don't go for what is God, who is God, based on your logic, which can calculate only very less levels. Don't go for deciding what is God, who is God, based on your understandings about your perceptions. The only way you can realize, cognize the reality, God, is apta pramana, the declarations of rishis, and atma pramana, declaration of your guru from his own realization. The apta pramana of rishis have become atma pramana of me. The realizations of rishis have become my realization. And if you internalize that, my realization will become your realization. The apta pramana of guru will become atma pramana of you. Understand? Here, consciousness, God is declaring, who is he? What is he? He is declaring about himself. Tadde jati, tannai jati, tadure, tadvantike. The word tat is translated as that here wrongly. The tat here will not mean that. The tat is truth. तत् एजति ट्रूथ वॉक्स, तत् नैजति ट्रूथ डज नॉट वॉक, तत् दूरे तत्वंतिके, इट इज फार ऑफ दैट इज ऑल्सो नियर, तद्दूरे तत्वंतिके, तत् अंतरस्य मीन्स दैट इज द इनर स्पेस, सर्वस्य फॉर एवरीथिंग, तत्तु सर्वस्यास्य बाह्यतः, ओनली व्हेन योर थर्ड आई इज अवेकन्ड यू विल अंडरस्टैंड देयर इज नो सच थिंग एज इनर आउटर. आई एम टेलिंग यू, दैट इज व्हाट इज द रिजल्ट ऑफ थर्ड आई अवेकनिंग. हाउ टू फाइंड आउट फॉर समबडी थर्ड आई इज फुल्ली अवेकन्ड, the idea of inner outer will disappear in them. You will see, my Gurukul kids will experience that. Actually, I am working with more and more powerful meditation process and techniques with the kids. When the third eye is opened, you will be able to see, perceive everything inside and outside without even knowing any difference or gap, completely freely. तद्दे जति तन्नै जति तद्दूरे तद्वंतिके, तत् अंतरस्य सर्वस्य तदु सर्वस्यास्य बाह्यतः. It is ignorance which reminds you, which makes you feel something is inside and outside, something is far off and near. It is like in the Ganga, one bamboo is floating. Because that bamboo is there, you say right side Ganga and left side Ganga. Ganga ever got divided? No. If you just remove that bamboo stick, Ganga got united? No. Neither division nor uniting ever happens is reality. Ganga is divided is perception. Right side Ganga, left side Ganga is fact. No, it is not divided, is truth. It can never be divided or united is reality. Listen, bamboo. Single bamboo stick can give you perception. Fact, truth, which does not exist. You can go on be arguing and establishing. तद्दे जति तन्नै जति तद्दूरे तद्वन्तिके. तद्दे जति तन्नै जति तद्दूरे तत्वन्तिके तदंतरस्य सर्वस्य तदु सर्वस्यास्य बाह्यतः द आइडिया ऑफ इनर आउटर मूव्स मूव्स नॉट ऑल दिस इज क्रिएटेड जस्ट लाइक बैंबू स्टिक क्रिएट्स डिविशन इन गंगा युअर इग्नोरेंस पावरलेसनेस creates division in you or appears to have created division in you. How you will handle the bamboo stick, you should handle exactly the same way your ignorance. You should know it can never divide you as inner and outer. It can never make you inside and outside. It can never make you moves and moves not. Today's Vakyartha Sadas is this one subject, bamboo stick, powerlessness stick. Understand this one example, what bamboo stick floating on the Ganga does to it, and what ignorance, powerlessness floating on you does to you. This example, if you merge, Ganga is your consciousness, bamboo stick is your powerlessness, right and left, which you call, is inside and outside, and moves, moves not, far off, near, all that. How, when you look at the small area, it really looks bamboo stick has divided Ganga. For an ant, that bamboo stick is equivalent to dam. Wow, such big dam. Ganga cannot touch me. I am protected. That bamboo stick, not even a ship, it's a dam for a for an ant. So how, when your perception is too small, what all the impact that bamboo stick powerlessness does in you, when your perception grows little bit and raises to a level of fact, what that bamboo stick does to Ganga and your powerlessness does to you, when you raise to the level of truth, what that bamboo stick does to Ganga and what your powerlessness does to you, when you raise to the level of reality, what that bamboo stick does to Ganga, what your powerlessness does to you, what that bamboo stick means to Ganga, what your powerlessness means to you. Have Vakyartha Sadas on this. You will understand, grasp, Tadde Jati, Tannai Jati, Taddure, तद्वन्तिके तदंतरस्य सर्वस्य तदु सर्वस्यास्य बाह्यतः. I bless you all. Let you all radiate with integrity, authenticity, responsibility, enriching, causing, living Advaita, eternal bliss, Nityananda. Thank you. Be blissful.
www.nityananda.org www.youtube.com/lifebliss foundation.